lot on my mind and, well, in it.
Let's get on with it. Onward, then.
Whoever's skulking about, show yourself!
Quite ready for you.
Indolence breeds madness.
Impero!
Invoco Apollo.
Blood follows me everywhere.
You do not recognize the language on the plaque.
What's that?
do not recognize the language on the plaque.
This place wasn't built for the living.
Armed scribes. No sign of a struggle.
I wonder what was so subversive about their words that they commanded protection. Jurgle? I didn't think anyone worshipped the scribe of the dead.
The inscription is in a language unknown to you.
Let them come. The darkness can be to our advantage.
I am fury. I am death.
My faith will protect me. Got to move.
Know what hit him. into the chase.
I will ascend.
Shall be done.
Time to strike. To let up. You need to pick me up. Make way. Can't give up.
to keep the machine. Victory awaits. This is your end.
To surrender their valuables, even after death.
Something the matter? Something the matter? Speak. Something the matter? Fine. What's on your mind? You're not the kind of company. And I haven't forgotten that you saved my life aboard the.
Don't sleep well, flitting between dreams and nightmares. Maybe you wake up because you know something is wrong, or maybe you just get lucky.
Shit. No, no, it's not what it looks like. I swear. I wasn't going to hurt you. I just needed... Well, blood.
There, in the dim firelight, you see him for what he really is. A vampire, a slave to sanguine hunger.
I've never killed anyone. Well, not for food. I feed on animals, boars, deer, kobolds, whatever I can get. But it's not enough. Not if I have to fight. I feel so weak. If I just had a little blood, I could think clearer, fight better. Please.
A strange sensation courses through you, and your companion's mind unfolds, secrets half revealed.
Happening.
Something stirs deep within you, hungry and alert. It's taking something you'll never get back. His mind opens up, revealing cracked and quivering memories. At their heart, you see dark eyes commanding you to feed. You open your mouth and bite down, not into a tender neck, but into the twisting body of a rat. The only thing your master lets you eat.
Yes, I ate whatever disgusting vermin my master picked. So you can see why I'm slow to trust you. But I do trust you. And you can trust me. Thank you. Do you think you could trust me just a little further? I only need a taste. I swear. Ah, of course. I shall be gentle as a babe. Let's make ourselves comfortable, shall we?
Of ice into your neck, a quick, sharp pain that fades to throbbing numbness. Your breath catches, your pulse quickens. You lean into him, losing yourself. You can feel your blood racing, coursing through both your bodies. A gentle, numb feeling starts to spread. You can hear how weak your voice is. So can he, but he doesn't care. He's long past caring. You feel a little cold, but that's all. There's no more pain, no more fear, no more struggle. It's all over.
Oh no, something terrible's happened.
What's next?
Sorry, darling.
I haven't got time for underlings. If your boss wants to speak to me, I'm all pointy ears.
Enough waiting. I crave blood.
Not a good time.
First, I must heal.
You're here? Thank goodness. I was worried about you. You looked a little ill last night, but you've certainly recovered.
God damn it!
I understand you're upset, but let's not get carried away. Killed feels like a strong word. Not many corpses have your vigor. Now, I admit, I got carried away last night. I apologize. But look at you now, perfectly healthy. So let's not fall out over this. We still need each other, after all. A strong, well-fed vampire? I'm a powerful weapon. You'd be a fool to toss me aside now. Anyway, last night was an aberration. It will never happen again. What do you say? Can we let bygones be bygones? What? Look, I swear I won't come after yours. But anyone's? You know what I am now. I can fight with all my weapons, teeth included. And if I happen to drain the occasional bandit during a fight, what's the harm? They're just as dead. Excellent. Now, shall we go? I'm already feeling a little peckish.
Something's wrong. I feel... Ah! It hurts. Darkness, protect me. No! I'm fine. Forget it. It's nothing. I swear. You're not going to let this go, are you? I worship Shah, the mistress of the night. Now that you have the truth, please don't make a big fuss about it.
You worship Shah? Blimey. She and my beloved Mistra are not exactly friends.
True. I didn't think you'd react so pragmatically. Perhaps I should have told you sooner. Talk to me later. This day's been long enough already. Guess. You're wondering why I was in pain before. Best if we just get the subject out of the way now. The wound on my hand. It never quite heals. And sometimes it causes terrible pain to rip through me. It's my burden, though, from Lady Shah. I can feel her influence somehow. I cannot say. Not with what I can recall. But even then, it would not be for me to question her will. Lady Shah has her reasons. It's difficult to say. Sometimes I wonder if it's supposed to be guiding me, punishing me, testing me. But perhaps it's none of those. Perhaps it's completely random. I'd like to hope there's more to it than that. Some meaning that Lady Shah will reveal to me when the time is right. Until then, all I can do is endure. I don't think so, but you're sweet to ask. Maybe just be patient the next time you see me wince or cry out. It'll pass quickly enough. It always does. Pain is sacred to followers of Lady Shah. Pain will give way to loss and then to the peace of her eternal darkness. You can tolerate a great deal of suffering so long as it has meaning. I'm sure you do, but please try to understand that it's not something I can just talk about freely. There's potential in you. Let's see how you handle this. I am indeed a disciple of Shah, Mistress of the Night and Lady of Loss. I assume you've heard of her. Curious. Most are afraid of my lady. I think I did well by joining you. Most agreeable company. You already know my biggest secrets. What more can you ask? What, besides my life's calling and the greatest problem I've ever faced? Well, I like night orchids and can't swim. Is that the sort of thing you meant? It's a deal.